إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, my subject today, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Do not despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The subject has to do with the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is such an important subject because we were commanded to actually learn who Allah is. فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Learn لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And there are two ways, brothers and sisters in Islam, before I get into the subject, through which you can learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Way or method number one is reflecting upon His creations. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described those who are well grounded in knowledge, إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض. And those who reflect, ponder upon the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وخاطب الله سبحانه وتعالى المشركين في القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed those who commit shirk and kufr. أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبِلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ. Why don't they look at the camels, how it was created? وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ. And to the sky, how it's raised. وَإِلَى الْجِبَالِ كَيْفَ نُصِبَتْ. And how the mountains are pitched. وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ كَيْفَ سُطِحَتْ. And how earth is made even. أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ. وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا وَأَلْقَيْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ تَبْصِرَةً وَذِكْرًا لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مُنِيبٍ. يعني ولله المثل الأعلى. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the highest and the best example. When you see something beautiful in front of you, right away you ask, who made this? Here is this universe around you. It reflects the creator of Allah, the creator, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this case. The second way, brothers and sisters in Islam, to learn about Allah is the text, the Quran and the Sunnah. Do you know the greatest verse in the Quran? سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح البخاري كتاب التفسير. This question to Ubay ibn Ka'b. Ya Ubay, أتدري أعظم آية في كتاب الله? Do you know the greatest verse in the book of Allah? Ubay right away said, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه آية الكرسي الآية. The whole ayah, brothers and sisters in Islam, talks about who Allah is. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ubay ibn Ka'b, هَنِيئًا لَكَ الْعِلْمِ يَا أَبَا الْمُنْذِرِ. You got it. This is the greatest verse in the Quran. Do you know that there is one surah equals third of the Quran? Third of the Quran. Hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri and the Muslim. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَيَعْجَزُ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَقْرَأَ ثُلُثَ الْقُرْآنِ فِي لَيْلَةِ. Is any of you unable to recite third of the Quran in his night? قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدُ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدُ. The whole surah, the whole chapter talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وبعدين يا إخوة, the problem, يعني the scholars, they divide the religion into two sections. They tell you, العلم الشرعي, the knowledge of the religion, falls into two areas. العلم بالله والعمل لله. That you know who Allah is. اللي هو التوحيد الخبري العلمي. You know who Allah is. And I'm telling you, any deficiencies that you have in your ibadah, in your worship, in your taqwa, is due to the fact lack of knowledge of who Allah is. ولذلك القرآن, you see the Quran connected the two. قال تعالى إنما يخشى الله, يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. علماء إيه؟ الماث, دكتور, انجينير؟ لا, علماء الدين, علماء الشريعة. من يعلم من الله؟ Indeed, those who have the taqwa and the fear of Allah are the most knowledgeable. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he heard those three individuals, Hadith al-Rahd and the Muslim, when he heard them making these statements, he came to the pulpit and he said, Wallahi, by Allah, أَنَا لَأَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَأَشَدُّكُمْ لَهُ خَشْيَةً. I am the most knowledgeable of you of who Allah is. And I am the most fearful of Allah. You see الربط, the relationship between knowledge and الخشية. ولذلك أنا أقول لك الأسماء والصفات, the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a garden. You really depriving yourself from it. Because if you get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find your heart compelled to fall in love with Allah. إذا علمت الرحمن الرحيم الغفور تحبه. Brothers and sisters in Islam, صفة الرحمة, the attribute of mercy, is established in the Quran and in the Sunnah. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given himself two names, and we recite them in the Salah 17 times every day. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. The merciful, the compassionate. Subhanallah, Rabbul Alameen. And this is the amazing piece, ya ikhwah. And that is why I said, do not despair from the mercy of Allah. كتب على نفسه الرحمة. He ordained, subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon himself mercy. قل لمن ما في السماوات والأرض. Ask them, O Muhammad, to whom belongs what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. قل لله كتب على نفسه الرحمة. He ordained upon himself mercy. بالرغم انه ايه, in spite of the fact what, هو الغني. He doesn't need any of us. He doesn't need any of his creation. ولذلك رب العالمين, وربك الغفور وربك الغني ذو الرحمة. وربك الغني, look, he is all sufficient and yet he possesses mercy. He is merciful. في الحديث في الصحيحين حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, لما خلق الله الخلق, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed the creation of the creating the creation, كتب كتابا هو عنده فوق عرشه, he wrote in a book he has on his throne, listen, إن رحمتي سبقت غضبي, my mercy precedes, comes before my anger. والرواية الأخرى, إن رحمتي غلبت غضبي, my mercy overtakes my anger. Oh. يا إخوة, ما اسم, ولذلك يعني يقول أهل العلم, this was a, لما, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about الاستواء على العرش, he did not say الله على العرش استوى, لا, الرحمن على العرش استوى. The most merciful did استواء on his throne. And there is a verse, there is a chapter, a whole chapter in the Quran named after الرحمن. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. So the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is established. We affirm it. لا نعطل الصفة. Now, what I really wanted to talk to you about is how vast, how great the mercy of Allah is. حتى الملائكة حملة العرش, look, الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما. O Allah, every single thing is encompassed, is engulfed by your knowledge and mercy. وفي سورة الأعراف, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء, and my mercy encompasses every single thing. ولذلك يا إخوة, لما الأعرابي اللي بال في المسجد, the Bedouin, حديث أبي هريرة, the Bedouin who urinated in the masjid, يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم treated him with mercy, with kindness. في أحد طرق هذا الحديث, in one of the wording of this hadith, he made this دعاء, اللهم ارحمني ومحمدا ولا ترحم معنا أحدا. O Allah, have mercy on me and Muhammad and no one else. Bedouin يعني. Oh. فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم right away said to him, لقد حجرت واسعة. You confine something that encompasses everything to you and me. ولعمر بن عبد العزيز مقولة مشهورة, اللهم إن لم أكن أهلا لرحمتك فرحمتك أهلا لي, فإنها وسعت كل شيء وأنا شيء, فالتسعني رحمتك أرحم الراحمين. O Allah, if I'm not qualified to receive your mercy, but your mercy reaches me, because you said in the Quran your mercy encompasses every single thing, and I'm a thing, so let it reach me, O Allah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we bring the subject of mercy, الرحمة. Normally you try to imagine your audience. لأن الموضوع يفتح باب الرجاء. يعني when we speak about the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, it increases your hope, your chances. It makes you feel like, I think I'm going to make it. You know what? Inshallah, I'm going to go to Jannah. I'm okay. It does. But when you really bring that subject up, you find the people who are not aware or do not comprehend well the vast or the greatness of the mercy of Allah are three groups. And they fall into mistakes. Yani, let me explain this. Maybe you got confused here. There are three types of people fall in trouble or get in trouble because they don't understand the mercy of Allah and how great it is. The first group are the disbelievers, al-kafir. Why? Because he already despaired from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Ankabut, he says, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَلِقَائِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَئِسُوا مِنْ رَحْمَتِي. Anyone who disbelieves in my ayat and in my mercy, he has already despaired. In my ayat and my meeting, in the day of resurrection, يعني, he has already despaired from my mercy. فالكافر, ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما في الصحيحين حديث أبي هريرة, لو يعلم الكافر ما عند الله من الرحمة ما يأس من دخول الجنة. If the disbeliever knows how much mercy Allah has, he will never despair from entering Jannah. ولذلك يا إخوة, when we speak to non-Muslims, first of all, we're supposed to talk to them about Allah. يعني أنا حقيقة نعتب على أنفسنا. Sometimes we overdo it once we talk about the wrath, the anger, the punishment. But we need to bring out the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how you attract them. This is how you get them to believe, to love Allah. And subhanallah, يعني يؤذون الله سبحانه وتعالى. يعني when the scholars decided to distinguish between the two names, the merciful and الرحيم, اللي هو الرحمن والرحيم. يعني when they wanted to distinguish, draw the line, what is the difference between the two? يعني one of the statements that Allah سبحانه وتعالى is merciful to all His creation, مؤمنهم وكافرهم في الدنيا ولكنه رحيم بالمؤمنين في الآخرة. So the first name الرحمن belongs to everyone in the dunya, whether he is a mu'min, a believer, whether he is a Muslim or a disbeliever, everyone qualifies to receive the mercy of Allah in the dunya. But in الآخرة, الرحيم, the compassionate, is for the believers only. شوف انت مثلا, يعني just to share with you, المشرك هذا يؤذي الله سبحانه وتعالى ويشتمه. The مشرك, the one who commits shirk, harms Allah, يعني in the sense that nothing can harm Allah, but in the sense he says things that are harmful. الحديث, حديث البخاري, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, يؤذين ابن آدم وما ينبغي له ذلك. The son of Adam says things that are harmful and he is not entitled to do this. وشتمن ابن آدم, he insults me and he has no right to do this. You insult Allah by saying Allah has a son. Ya ikhwa, when you hear that person saying Allah has a son, this is a great thing. This is a great in the negative meaning. Yeah. This is a bad thing, yeah. The worst thing that a person can say. Oh, as for the fact that you belie Allah, كذبني, هذا هو اللفظ. كذبني, he belies me. Oh, belies me. That you say, when we say that Allah cannot give us life after death, when we die, خلاص. No resurrection. And when I created him at first. طب انت شوف شوف هذه, look. حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه في صحيح مسلم, لا أحد أصبر على أذى يسمعه من الله. No one is more patient over harmful things that he hears but Allah. He hears those people saying that he has a son. He hears them belying the fact that he will resurrect them again. وَيَرْزُقُهُمْ وَيُعَافِيهِمْ. And he still provides for them. He still gives them health. He still gives them wealth. Why? اسم الله الرحمن. هو الرحمن. ولذلك يا إخوة أنت في نكتة عجيبة. اسم الله الرحمن, the name of Allah الرحمن, was not mentioned in any surah more than Surah Maryam. حتى في سورة الرحمن لم يذ يعني if you count the how many times the name Ar-Rahman was mentioned in Surah Maryam, you will find it more than any other surah in the Quran. You know why? Because those two issues were raised in that surah. The story of Maryam and the birth of Isa, and the fact the Jews, the Christians, they say Allah begets a son. And also the other story, the other issue was mentioned. وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانُ أَإِذَا مَا مِتُّ لسوف أخرج حيا. The same, the two issues were mentioned. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, has it been for the name Ar-Rahman, the merciful, I would have taken them. But because of that name. وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِمَا كَسَبُوا مَا تَرَكَ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ. Because I'm merciful. And I already ordained to delay everything till the day of resurrection. ولذلك يا إخوة يقولون, Ibn Abbas says في تفسير قول الله تعالى about Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you, O Muhammad, but a mercy to all mankind. يقول ابن عباس, هو رحمة للبر والفاجر. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is a mercy for the wicked and for the righteous. How, Ibn Abbas? He is saying, for the wicked, that Allah doesn't seize him in the dunya. He delays him. And he actually makes him benefit. وطبعاً الرحمة للمؤمن في الدنيا والآخرة. This is the first group, the disbelievers. They don't understand how much mercy Allah has over them. Here they are associating in worship with him. They're saying Allah is one of three. They're saying Allah is the Father, the Son, the Holy. And yet he still gives them. He still blesses them. He still provides for them in the dunya. If a non-Muslim knows that, and these meanings has to reach their brothers and sisters in Islam. The second group, quickly. المسلم العاصي اللي رد. There are some brothers, alhamdulillah, they went the wrong way. And they normally come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But shaitan plays a very interesting game on them. لا يغفر الله. Allah is not going to forgive you. You're done. You're doomed. Oh. The brother comes in, I don't know if Allah is going to forgive me or not. I really did so much. I did so much. يعني I'll give you a story of this man that will explain that meaning. حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه في البخاري ومسلم. أسرف رجل على نفسه. Look at this now. Somebody from the nation of Bani Israel overdid it. He did everything. يعني in one of the wording of this hadith, he used to go and steal the shrouds after you bury the deceased. يعني you go bury the deceased, he goes digs the grave, open it, steal the shrouds, and he would sell it. وصلت به الأمر كان يسرق القبور. فالرجل يعني for him that sin is an فwhen he is about to die, he called upon his children. دعا أولاده. What kind of a father was I to you? قالوا نعم الأب. A good father. Now I want you to do something. After I die, burn my body, smash my bones, ثم انتظروا, then wait for a windy day, then cast my ashes half in the sea, half in the land. شوف, فإنه إن قدر الله علي ليعذبني عذابا ما عذبه أحدا من العالمين. وهذه التي أنقذت أهل العلم كلهم. يقول لك إيه, has it been, if Allah سبحانه وتعالى is able to bring me back, he will punish me a punishment that no other person will be punished. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the earth, bring forth, the sea, bring forth. Huh? Why did you do this? قَالَ مَخَافَتُكَ يَا رَبِّ. Your fear, ya Allah. فَغَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Allah forgave his sins. But الشاهد, the point that I'm trying to make is, that person thought that no chance for him. He's done. That's why he did this. والرجل الثاني, عندك القصة الثانية, قاتل 99. Somebody went, the person, حديث أبي سعيد في البخاري, he killed 99 souls. He went to the person who looks like a scholar, but he doesn't know his stuff. هل لي من توبة? Do I have a chance? No. قتل. He killed him. You see, if you despair from the forgiveness and the mercy of Allah, this will lead you to what? Carry on. وبعدين, why do you do this? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon you in the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not despair from the mercy of Allah. Look at this. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgives all sins. يا إخوة, في سنن الترمذي, حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه, يا ابن آدم لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. If your sins, if you commit sins that reaches السماء, the heavens, the sky. ليه? Why? Because Allah forgives. Allah forgives, يا إخوة. And His mercy, His forgiveness is out, is inconceivable. You cannot even conceive it. Why do you give up? Why do you spare from the mercy of Allah? Just come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, إن الله يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends His hand, and we believe, we affirm that Allah has a hand. We don't reject the attribute, but should we liken it like our hands? The answer is no. Should we try to visualize His hand? No. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every day, in the morning, every day, during the day, He's waiting for you to repent. And every night, He's waiting for you to repent. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. And again, we believe that Allah descends. We believe, we do not reject the attribute of descending. But do we know how? No, we don't. Does He descend like us? No, because we're not like Him. We're not like Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not like His creation in any form or shape at all. But we believe that He descends. When the last third of the night is here, He descends and He calls upon you. هل من مستغفر فأغفر له؟ هل من تائب فأتوب عليه؟ ف as a Muslim, as a believer, you should not despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive that you commit shirk, but He will forgive every single thing. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the last category of people here who fail to understand the vastness of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are people who normally would let people despair from that mercy. يعني حديث جندب بن عبد الله في صحيح مسلم, a man who is righteous, يعني he does righteous deeds, said to another person who is sinful, look at this, والله لا يغفر الله لك. شوف هذا, this is somebody who is ignorant of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says to the sinner, by Allah, Allah will not forgive you for what you're doing. كلام هذا, this happened at the time of Bani Israel. Allah revealed to the prophet of the time, من هذا الذي يتألى علي? Who is taking my place? Who is taking an oath on me? Look, غفرت له وأحبطت عملك. I forgiven his sins and you start working over. All your past righteous deeds are in vain. Again, don't. Well, I already shared with you the story of the 99, the killer of the 99. The person says to him, no, Allah will not. After killing 99, no way. He killed him. This is how we should give people hope when we speak about the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In closing, why should we learn about the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, في حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, والحديث متفق عليه, إن لله 99 اسما من أحصاها دخل الجنة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names. Whosoever does ihsa, and I use the Arabic intentionally, he will enter Jannah. Now there is an issue here we have to settle. Are the names of Allah are just 99? The answer is no. اللهم إني أسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو احتفظت به في علم الغيب عندك. The names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are countless. ولذلك the people make a mistake once they write the 99 names. يقول لك أسماء الله خلاص. لا, أسماء الله لا تحصى ولا تعد. والحديث الآخر يا إخوة, حديث الشفاعة الكبرى, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes and intercedes for mankind, يقول فأسجد تحت العرش, I will prostrate in front of the throne of Allah, ثم يفتح الله علي بمحامد لم تفتح على أحد من قبلي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal to me names and attributes that no other person has praised him with these names and attributes before. But there are 99 out of these names and the attributes. You will enter Jannah. What do you mean by ahsaha? Number one, understanding it properly. Ya ikhwa, this door of names and attributes, a lot of people went astray in it. That you understand the names of Allah the way that our righteous predecessor understood it. Number one, rule number one, do not reject the name nor the attribute. If Allah says, I have a hand, done. He has a hand. I have a face, done. Do not reject it. There are people who rejected that. لا نعطل. Two, لا تتأول. Do not interpret it. Do not misinterpret it. يعني, the people say, ثم استوى على العرش. Allah rose above the throne. The people, they come and say, well, rose above that, that's no. Istawla. Oh. That he messes up, he alter the attribute, whether literally by saying other words or the meanings. يعني الرحمة هذه, when you read that hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends when the last third of the night is here. There are people in the ummah who says what? Allah doesn't descend, but the mercy of Allah descends. يا أخي هذا كلام. هذا كلام. لا. You have to accept it without altering it. لفظاً ومعنى. You cannot change the word, nor you can alter the meaning. Meaning you تتأول لفظ ثاني, معنى ثاني. Number three, do not liken it to us. Because Allah is not like us. We're not like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, or number three, do not visualize it. Do not visualize it. Don't make an image. يعني انت تقرأ, انت عند اليهود هذا المعنى موجود اصلا من ايام اليهود. يقول لك ايه, you shall not, the first command, look at this, you shall not take a god before me, and don't make an image of God. Image here means an idol or an image in your brain. You cannot do that. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. None is like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هكذا. The first thing that you understand it properly, the way that our righteous predecessors understood. We're talking about man ahsaha, whoever does ihsa. Number two, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. يا رحمن ارحمني, يا رحيم ارحمني, يا رزاق ارزقني, يا كريم اكرمني, يا عفو. Oh, فانت, you learn these names and the attributes in order to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it. But it's not necessarily that you call requesting something. يعني سبحان الله, إثني على الله, ثناء على الله بها, ثناء. ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها. الدعاء أحيانا يا أخو فقط للثناء على الله سبحانه وتعالى. يعني أنت تعجب في دعاء الكرب, حديث ابن عباس في البخاري. Look, the دعاء of the distress, if you're distressed, if you're having problems, you know what you're supposed to say? لا إله إلا الله العظيم الحليم, لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم, لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش الكريم. Where is the دعاء? What did you ask here? Did you ask? You didn't ask, but أثنيت على الله. When you praise Allah, Allah knows what you want. He will give it to you. يقول لك من قال لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد, يحيي ويميت وعلى كل شيء قدير. 100 times a day, Allah will forgive all his sins, even if it is as many as the foam of the sea. Did you ask Allah to forgive you? You did not. أنت فقط أثنيت عليه. And when you praise him, he knows what you want. خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة, وخير ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبل, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. فين الدعاء؟ فالإنسان الدعاء مش لازم يكون حاجة. ما هو الدعاء إما حاجة إما عادة إما عبادة وإما ثناء. ممكن ثناء تثني على الله سبحانه وتعالى بهذه الأسماء. You praise Allah. ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها. Call upon him using these names. دعاء حاجة, ثناء, or so forth. The last piece here, أن تتلبس بالأسماء. ولذلك سبحان الله تجد هذا الربط العجيب في حديث يا إخوة في مصنف ابن أبي شيبة, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما. Listen, الراحمون يرحمهم الرحمن, ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. If you're merciful with the people, the merciful will have mercy on you. Issue, ya ikhwa, that we have as Muslims, as a community, we don't have mercy in dealing with one another. We, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم, الرحمة, that we have mercy. If you have mercy on me, I have mercy on you, the most merciful will have mercy on us. وبعدين رب العالمين also الله سبحانه وتعالى addressed a very important issue that we have. حديث في سنن الترمذي وسنن الإمام أبي داود حديث عبد الرحمن بن عوف رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says قال الله تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى says أنا الرحمن I am the most merciful وهذا الرحم and this is the womb. The womb, ya ikhwa, where the baby is carried for 9 months, in Arabic it's called al-rahim. In English, of course, called the womb. But al-rahim. Shaqaqtu laha isman min ismi. I made the name of the womb derives from my name, al-rahman. Al-rahman. Look. Faman wasalaha wasaltuh. What is going on with your families? What is going on with your kins? Are you calling your brothers, your sisters? Huh? Whoever maintain relationship with his kins, I will have a relationship with him. وَمَنْ قَطَعَهَا قَطَعْتُهُ And if you sever, you cut your kins, I will cut you. I don't know you. Oh. يعني المعنى هنا what I want to say is if you have mercy on one another الزوج the husband have mercy on your wife we have a lot of family issues ارحم زوجتك يا أخي ارحم أولادك have mercy on your children فين الرحمة يا إخوة ما هو learning about the names and the attributes of Allah see how Allah سبحانه وتعالى one person killed 100 people he still went to Jannah A woman who was a prostitute, she was merciful to a dog. To a dog, she went to Jannah. Lee, why we're not having mercy in the way that we deal with one another? هذا هو المعنى. This is the real meaning behind learning about the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In closing, I don't want to prolong this. Just for the sake of knowledge. اسم الله الرحمن The name of Allah, Ar-Rahman, no human being can take it. No one can call himself Rahman. But Ar-Rahim, you can. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. Why? لأن اسم الله الرحمن has to do with the attribute of mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. صفة للذات. And there is one person who called himself that. And subhanallah, he is known until the end of time to be the liar. Musaylimah. Someone who claimed to be a messenger. He called himself, Ana Rahmanu al-Yamama. I am the merciful of al-Yamama. Subhanallah, any time that you mention Musaylimah, Al-Kadhab. Musaylimah, the liar. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرحمنا اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك اللهم انزل علينا رحمتك يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اسرافنا في أمرنا ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم ربنا انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن قولوا قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم